Hi everyone, I'm Stephanie Crawford and welcome to Mrs. Cford Vlogs. I wanted to take just a few minutes today to talk about something that I think at this time of the year, especially with me in the Midwest, cold weather, we haven't necessarily seen the sun a lot. We've been cooped up indoors, a lot of us. We all start to get kind of that spring fever. The idea of professionalism and compassion within our students is something that we're always worried about. You know, we try to correct those behaviors, help them be empathetic, to think of others, to be compassionate towards others, and even if they have a different viewpoint, to still be willing to listen, to still be polite. We talk about how body language is a big indicator of how you're accepting a person and their conversation with you. We talk about, you know, if you get new students in at this time of the year, being welcoming, inclusive, opening yourself up, and I guess it goes with that bigger topic of building relationships. So we do all of this with our students and we expect more from them. And when we are frustrated, a lot of times we'll say, I just don't know why they won't open up, or I wish they would be more empathetic and try to walk in that other person's shoes or listen to another person's viewpoint. And those things frustrate us. But as we're in this springtime, or closing in on springtime, and we kind of get that cabin fever and we're stressed out from the school year, from the paperwork, maybe from the lessons, from some, maybe sometimes the kids, whatever it is, the time constraints, maybe it's stuff outside of our job, but it all can help weigh on us at times, and this time of the year can be stressful. I just wanted to take this time as a reminder for us that we need to also have that professionalism and that compassion for others that we want our students to have. We talk all the time about modeling something that we're doing in class, showing them how it can be done and practicing it because we want them to do it. We have to do the same even when they're not watching. I mean, isn't that, if you have kids of your own, you know, you probably have said that before. You know, it's about doing what's right when no one's watching, that you're gonna continue doing those things that you're asking them to do because it's the right thing to do. We don't always follow that. When we're in those meetings, when we have ideas that don't mesh with what we want, or when we're just having a bad day, or we feel like we're not prepared for a change, any of that, excuse me, any of that that can weigh down on us on top of all of those other things, it's easy to go into a situation where you're meeting with other teachers and you're closed off. It's easy to have that, you know, crossed arm body language. It's easy to avoid eye contact or roll your eyes or do heavy sighs. Those are things that are fallbacks for us all, I think, at some points, when we're frustrated. And I know that I've been guilty of the same thing. So at this time of the year, I just wanted to give that reminder that you need to be aware of what you're doing. Walk in, try to have that positive attitude, even if you're sure that it's going to be the worst meeting you've ever gone to and that there's absolutely nothing that you're going to take away from it. Go in there with the idea that it's still a chance to get to know someone else that you don't know very well. It's a chance to listen to someone else's idea and find out why they feel so strongly about something that you feel exactly the opposite about. Do it with compassion, do it with kindness, do it with professionalism. You know, make your voice heard. If you feel strongly, make your voice heard, but be professional about it. Be compassionate that other people might have a different experience or might be having things going on that you're not aware of, and treat everyone as you would want your kids to treat each other. You know, again, our students look to us as models. So even if they're not always around us, sometimes, you know, they might hear stories. Sometimes we have someone watching when we're not aware. Try to think of it that way too if it's hard. But the whole moral is, let's try to have more of a positive outlook. Be professional, be compassionate, practice what we're telling our students to do. And then you'll find greater joy in your life also, I think, in those hard times. Not to discount anything that we're going through on our own, but just so that we're aware that, you know, we still have that ability to make someone else smile or to make them upset. And we have to choose to help uplift those other people. At least I think that's our responsibility. So again, just a little reminder as we go through this stretch, again in the Midwest here, it's cold still, we're ready for spring. We get that cabin fever, our kids have it too. Just choose kindness, choose compassion, choose professionalism. Even if you don't agree, you don't have to agree, you just need to be kind about it. All right, I hope you're having a great day, a great week. And if you enjoyed what you saw, please like and subscribe. And I'll see you next time on Mrs. Cford Vlogs.